my name is Kurt Worley. I am the quantitative analyst at fxbootcamp.com. Today is Friday, January 14th, 2011. This is your New York session video technical briefing. It's a video review of some of the price action we covered in the live class today at fxbootcamp.com during the New York session. Before I get started, I'd like to request your feedback. Please leave a comment when you're done watching this video. Even if you just say hi or thanks, I would really appreciate that. Now I'd like to clarify that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not an alert service. The currency coaches do not make trade recommendations, but we do provide real-time technical and fundamental analysis to help you put together your trade plans throughout the day, and we remind everyone that past trading performance does not predict future results. Do not trade money you cannot afford to lose. What you now see is a 15-minute chart for the British pound Japanese yen currency pair, as that chart looked at 9 a.m. New York time on GFT's Dealbook 360 trading platform. And yes, you heard me right. I'm actually delivering a review of price action on a yen pair. If you've been attending my live coaching sessions at some point over the past 3 months, you probably know that I haven't been very thrilled with the prospects for profiting from intraday trades on the so-called yen crosses. Simply put, the Japanese yen's recent performance against the major currencies has been very mixed. Now, one scenario for trading the yen cross that I have mentioned in the past and mentioned again today during my coaching session, that scenario is buying or selling a base currency like the British pound when the US dollar shows the same directional bias as that base currency. Consider today's case. We saw the British pound broadly firm against silver currencies. Unfortunately, the US dollar had also been firm. Trading one strong currency against another strong currency is not only hard work, it can be frustrating. Better to pair up the pound with the yen, especially considering what this pair has done since the start of the month. The pound yen has finished the trading day higher than it started the trading day on 7 of the past 9 days. Looking at the upper right hand portion of this chart, this pair made a new high right there, a new high for the month, about an hour ago. So it wasn't crazy to look for an opportunity to long the pound yen today. If you're bullish, you're looking to buy the dips. That is, dips to a likely area of support. As for sources of prospective support, you could immediately identify a roughly 5 pip zone right in through there, which I've identified on the right-hand side of the chart. That zone defined by the psychological level at 131, that level represented by the thin horizontal blue line, and today's central pivot point. The central pivot point represented here by the thicker horizontal black line at 130.95. Now, closer inspection of the price action over the past 24 hours reveals what could be another prospective source of support. Notice the lower highs on the left-hand side of this chart. I've just identified those lower highs with blue arrows. Also note the swing low formed right there, just above 131. Now let's connect those, the lower highs and the recent swing low, with a black trend line and extend that trend line forward in time. Since the pound yen broke above that trend line earlier, right in there, that trend line might become support later on. Also, I can use the move up from today's low here near the bottom of the chart to the new high for the month up there at the upper right hand portion of the chart. I can use that move up as the basis for a Fibonacci study. The 50% Fib retracement level of that move up is represented here by the horizontal lime green line sitting right at 131. Now that 50% Fib level is very popular among traders. Now given all of that, it was reasonable to enter a long trade at or just below 131 when this pair reached that area about an hour and 15 minutes later. By the way, looking in the lower right-hand portion of the chart, the arrival of stochastics in the oversold territory at the same time also helped confirm the case for that long. Now, if you took the shot long, your stop, again, the entry at or just below 131 right in there. If you took the shot, your stop loss could be positioned just below today's low for catastrophic protection purposes, and your exit strategy could be to take a modest loss if the pound yen dips below this upper sloping green line representing the 200 EMA. At the time, the 200 EMA was just below 130.80. By the time you're 25 pips in profit, you're probably moving your stop loss to break even and taking profit just below the weekly R2 pivot point less than 10 minutes before London close, which wasn't such a bad idea at all. London close represented here by the vertical red line. Now that move from daily center pivot point, again right there, to the weekly R2 pivot point right there. By the way, the daily R2 pivot point was just 10 points above that weekly R2. The central pivot point to weekly R2 pivot point move, that move covered 83 pips. Now, 2 hours after that, Coach David Pegler wrapped up our first week-long trading marathon of the year. Special thanks to everyone who participated. Again, my name is Kurt Worley, and this has been your New York Session video briefing from fxbootcamp.com for Friday, January 14th.